coming to you from our GIS studios. I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. The Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Empowerment, and Local Government hosted an internal assessment training program with the objective of improving on the report writing and interviewing skills of the field staff, which include social workers and interns. The two-day training exercise was facilitated by the Acting Director of the Division of Human Services, Beverly Ann Poyot. Nyla James, Family Caseworker at the Division of Human Services, stated that the training reinforced the importance of remaining factual when doing the assessments. The two-day training program took place from Wednesday the 12th of February to Thursday the 13th of February 2020 at the Division of Human Services office. On Sunday, the 16th of February 2020, the Parliamentary Representative for Mikud North, Honourable Dr. Gail Rigobert, spent the day along with the administrator, teachers, facilitators, and parents of the past year's preschool preparing the facility to receive the students on Monday, the 17th of February. The minister expressed gratitude to the SSDF, corporate sponsors, citizens, the daycare centre, the Ministry of Education, and well-wishers who partnered with the Mikud North Parliamentary Office to make the return to school and the past year's preschool rehabilitation campaign a success. Officers from the SSDF have already visited the original site of the school and have begun the technical work in preparation for the reconstruction of the preschool. The Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment is preparing to roll out its participatory poverty assessment as part of the Enhanced Country Poverty Assessment Project, which is being administered throughout the OECS Commission. The stakeholders recently met in Saint Lucia to prepare for its implementation. The Enhanced Country Poverty Assessment Project is a qualitative and quantitative study of living conditions. The project is being funded by the Caribbean Development Bank and administered across the OECS through the OECS Commission. Recently, the OECS Commission engaged with the officials from the Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment to plan and prepare for the rollout of these other components, in particular the participatory poverty assessment. The OECS Commission has pledged its technical support to the implementation process. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.